I think I just really like looking through the camera, looking through a viewfinder, looking at the person, having camera in front of me and having that distance. I remember being a kid and having this one drawer in our house full of photographs, which I would go to pick up the box and ask my mum if I can have a look through it. So now I have glass and metal plates, not in the photo album, but in a photography box. The process which I use, it's what plate collodion, is to give the certain notion of time, but what we want to deal with is something very contemporary. So looking at Sherlock Holmes and paragraphs from Sherlock Holmes, which we just thought it could be nice to create something from today and which works with contemporary designers and young designers in London. It's not to create a Sherlock, as Sherlock, which was in the Sherlock Holmes book. It's more to create a man who lives in certain town. And I really like large format cameras with bellows, and I do like to be able to shift and tilt. And it's almost like a prototype of Polaroid. It's instant, so you see it straight away. You sort of have to process it before your chemistry dries out and becomes not sensitive to light anymore. So it's wet plate collodion. So you make everything on your own. You clean your plate, prepare your plate. If it's a glass, then you have to sort of spend a little bit of time making sure there's no dust on it. Then you pour over your collodion solution, which then is being soaked and dropped into a silver nitrate tank, where silver sort of particles penetrate the plate and make it light sensitive. Then you expose your plate to light, go back to the darkroom, develop it, use the water to stop the developing process and fix it. It's one of the first photography processes and it works in the same way. You know, I use a very sort of hands-on manual process. It's very connected with what I saw in here and what I've been exposed to in the past 10 years. London has a big influence on my work, because unconsciously I take a lot of things which I see around me, and because I cycle everywhere, I then find a lot of it in my work. And that's what I find really fascinating in the process I'm doing, because everything what I do, it's very, very manual. I don't see the notion of time anymore. I lost the pleasure of looking at Victorian photographs and appreciating them for Victorian photographs. I look at it and I see a young man or, a boy smiling. I just don't see them anymore as old photographs. I don't look at my work and I don't see the notion of time anymore. I just see them as photographs today.